You need to listen to this again and again. Okay, if you don't have questions, then I'll proceed. Right. What is revenge?
复仇,报仇,报复.
What does revenge mean in the Bible?
圣经里说,我要报复,要.
God says, I will revenge your enemy.
圣经说,我要报复你的仇敌.
Okay. And I always felt this is strange.
我觉得这句话写得很奇怪.
God always says, love your enemy. God says, I will revenge your enemy, I will kill them.
他说我会复仇, 报复你的仇敌, 杀死他们.
What does it mean?
什么意思?
It's a contradiction.
比较矛盾.
You have any idea? Okay. This is a very important part. And would you open the Bible, Revelation chapter 6, verse 10.
第十节, 大声喊着, 启示录书第六章第十节, 大声喊着说, 圣洁真实的主啊, 你不审判住在地上的人, 给我们生流血的冤, 要等到几时呢?
Verse 10, this is the scene that martyrs, right?
就是那些殉道的人在说的话.
Martyrs are asking for revenge, avenge.
那些殉道者们，他们在要上帝为他们复仇，报仇.
And we can. Whoa, these martyrs, who are the martyrs?
那谁是这些殉道者呢?
Well, you know, Abel, Cain killed Abel.
该隐杀了亚伯.
And is this saying that Abel says to God, oh, when are you revenge me and kill Abel?
那么亚伯会不会对上帝说, Cain says why? Abel says what Cain says. Excuse me, say that again.
No. See, this is up in heaven, right? Revelation chapter 6. Right? Because all of the martyrs.
所有这些圣徒都在喊.
And see, martyrs are real Christian, right?
其实这些殉道者才是真正的基督徒，对吗?
Let me ask you this, Dr. Kong. if someone killed you, and then you go to God and say, God, how long I have to wait until you kill my enemy? Are you gonna say that?
No.
Well, why are these martyrs saying that?
可是为什么他们会这么说呢?
因为他们
It means that chapter 6 and verse 10 means that why God endured their sins for so long. It's kind of God endurance.
That's right. Then what is avenging our blood means?
那什么是给我们身流血的冤是什么意思? So Jesus' blood, not our blood.
Avenge our blood, it says our blood.
是我们的血，不是耶稣的血，这个是。 So we are living because Jesus died.
See, and he said, "You judge and avenge our blood."
他说：“你要为我们审判，要为我们身流血的冤。” And how about Genesis chapter 4? It says verse 10. 你看创世纪第四章第十节, huh? And the Lord says, "What you have done, Cain, your brother Abel's blood in his."
Yeah. What that means, that's right. This is the same thing. Abel's blood cried out to me.
Yeah, cry out.
Yeah. What did Abel cry out?
所以他说，你兄弟的血，亚伯向我哭喊。那亚伯的血都哭了些什么？
So it means, God, avenge my blood.
亚伯是在说，上帝，你为我流血这个事儿报仇啊。
What did avenge means when Abel said that?
所以当亚伯说报仇的时候是什么意思呢?
Because Abel lost the blood.
因为亚伯流干了血。
Because Cain hit Abel.
该隐打了他。And
Abel says, "Avenge my blood."
所以亚伯说，请你为我的血伸冤。And
someone hits you.
当有人打你。
You bled to death.
然后流血死亡,
and as you die,
当你死的时候,
as Stephen to die,
当斯提凡死的时候,
he cried out, avenge.
他们这么喊, 复仇, 为我的血伸冤。
Avenge.
And also,
avenge? Yeah, avenge.
And also, Luke chapter 18, verse 6 and 7 says, "Oh, look at this unrighteous judge, and God's elected people have been crying to him." He said, "For how long have I endured for that? And why not revenge for us?"
Mm-hmm. What is that revenge?
Mm-hmm. What's that revenge?
Yeah.
And he says, "I tell you, now I'll revenge quickly when the Son of Man comes on them." This is about another one.
See. This revenge is a beautiful word. See, when Abel said that, when God says, "The blood of Abel cries out to me."
当亚伯说，上帝说亚伯的血在向我哭哀告。
And to me, Abel said to God, Abel prayed to God.
亚伯祷告对上帝说,
"Oh God,
他说上帝啊,
help my brother Cain.
你要帮助我的弟弟哥哥该隐。
And my brother Cain is captured by Satan.
他说我的哥哥该隐被撒旦抓住了。
And I'm dying. Please save him out of Satan.
求你救他脱离撒旦的手。
That's the meaning of the revenge.
That's the meaning when God uses the word revenge. See, so when Stephen was dying,
当斯蒂凡死的时候,
Stephen asked for the revenge.
所以斯蒂凡要伸冤,
and God answered that prayer.
上帝就听了他的祷告。
And God saved the Paul.
上帝就救了这个保罗。
And when Stephen and Paul meet in heaven,
我们想一下，在天国的时候，斯蒂凡看到保罗的时候，
What is Stephen gonna say to God?
这时候斯蒂凡会对上帝说什么呢？ Thank you for your revenge.
That's right. Thank you for revenge. Yeah. Isn't this wonderful?
你看上帝的这个声讨，这个声冤是多么不同。
Yeah. You ask, you answer my prayer.
你听了我的祷告。
Okay, let's prove that point.
让我们来证实一下这一点。
And let's go to Romans chapter 12.
我们看一下罗马书第十二章。
Verse 17. Repay no one evil for evil.
不要以恶报恶.
And verse 18.
18节.
If it is possible.
倘若能行，若是能行.
Okay. Then verse 19.
看十九节.
Go ahead.
亲爱的弟兄，不要自己伸冤，宁可让步，听凭主怒。 因为经上记着，主说：“深渊在我，我必报应。”
Vengeance is mine, I will repay, says the Lord. Right? Verse 19.
所以十九节这里说：“深渊在我，我必报应。”
So when God is avenging,
当上帝报应的时候，
then verse 20.
所以上帝是这样子，二十节说：“所以你的仇敌若饿了，就给他吃；若渴了，就给他喝，因为你这样行，就是把炭火堆在他的头上。”Love
your enemy, right?
爱你的仇敌。But
here's something strange here.
大家注意到这里面是挺有意思、挺奇怪的。
It says, for in doing so you will heap the coals of fire on his head.
这里说，因为你这样行，就是把炭火堆在他的头上。
What does it mean?
什么意思啊？
This cause of fire
炭火,
is very important word.
炭火非常重要，是什么？
If you don't understand the cause of fire, then this is very strange.
如果人不明白炭火，就会觉得这句话写的挺怪的。
Is God really asking
the power of God?
Power of God. In terms of doing what?
Equal to love.
That's right. Yes. Yes. So, because, see, in the heavenly sanctuary,
在这个天上的圣所,
and there is a burning coal.
有这个着着的炭火,
which burns the sacrifice.
是烧这个祭坛上的物品的,
see, burning the sacrifice means burning our sin, forgiving us.
那么这个炭火燃烧的时候就表明我们的罪被赦免被烧掉。
And so, if you go back to the Old Testament,
如果大家回头看旧约,
you'll find the cause of fire several times.
很多次提到炭火,
in the book of Ezekiel.
在这个以西结书,
or the book of and book of Isaiah too.
在以赛亚书,
let's go to Isaiah.
看一下以赛亚书, chapter 6.
6.
以赛亚书第六章。
66。我们看一下第六章第六节，有一撒拉佛飞到我眼前，手里拿着红炭，是用火剪从坛上取下来的。 Right, that's a forgiving.
这就是饶恕。And
the verse 7.
我们继续看第七节，将炭沾我的口，说：看了，这炭沾了你的嘴，你的罪孽便除掉，你的罪恶就赦免。
So this call fire is forgiving Holy Spirit. So putting a fire, call of fire upon the head means enemy's head means.
所以把炭火放在敌人的头上是说,
on the head means understand.
所以头不是指的理解吗?
So understanding, forgiving love of God.
所以能够理解上帝饶恕你的爱.
That's the revenge.
这就是上帝的复仇深渊.
So let's go back to Romans 12 again.
我们回到罗马书第十二章.
There's one more thing I'd like to point out.
还有一点，跟大家说一说。
Here, verse 19.
我们看十九节.
Do not avenge yourselves.
不要自己伸冤.
And this means if we avenge ourselves, we kill the enemy.
什么叫自己伸冤? 不就是杀仇敌吗?
But rather give place to wrath.
所以要让步, 要干什么呢?
Is that interesting?
要听凭主怒, yeah. 有意思.
So this anger is also love of God.
所以这里的主怒还是上帝的爱。
For it is written, vengeance is mine, I repay them. Therefore, if in verse 20, if your enemy is hungry, feed him, thirsty, give him drink.
所以第十九节说，主说，伸冤在我，我必报应。那上帝是怎么做呢？ 仇敌饿了就给他吃，渴了就给他喝。
So even revenge is salvation.
其实在这里伸冤还是指的救恩。
Finally, we can be, you know, we can understand whole Bible in the character, in the love of God.
所以如果我们从上帝爱的角度，上帝的品德来看的话，就能够看明白整本的圣经。
Then Book of Revelation become entirely different.
然后启示录就会看得不同了。And
then you need to ask me a question.
然后大家还是得问问题。
Then what is Noah's flood?
那么挪亚的洪水呢?
Don't you want to ask me that question?
想挪亚的洪水吗?
not flood punishment.
It's God's
revenge. Is the God revenge?
By killing them?
By saving Noah. By saving Noah.
Hmm? What is the flood? Noah's flood. You don't have to look in the Bible, that's the thing.
Mm.
Okay, let me explain the flood.
讲讲这个洪水.
Okay. And it's on chapter 6 of Genesis.
Mm, chapter
6. When God created earth,
当上帝创造世界的时候,
He divided water.
他把水分开了,
and created firmament.
然后创造了一个气层,
so in this space, God created earth.
然后在这个最底层创造了地,
so it is water above, water below.
然后就有地上的水和地, 天上的水.
This is a great power.
这是一个很大能,
to keep water separated.
使水分开.
Right now we are living in that power.
现在我们就生活在上帝的全能下.
If God removes that power, what happens?
若上帝把这全能拿走撤掉,
flood.
洪水.
When that can happen?
什么时候会发生呢?
If whole world refuse create.
当全世界都拒绝创造主的时候,
God is not going to revenge us.
上帝不会报复.
It is God's justice to remove His power when world refuses.
这就是上帝 世界拒绝上帝的时候，他撤走了自己的权柄。
Everyone in the world says, "We don't want you."
世界上所有人都说，哎，我们不要你。
God will have tears in his eyes.
上帝也会哭哈。
And he will remove his power.
他都会撤走自己的这个权柄。
And water will come down.
水又会合在一起。
Yes. So, in God's anger, sadness, in God's tears, the flood came.
所以就是在上帝这种流泪当中、义务当中,
because everybody at that time on earth refused Creator.
因为地上所有的人都拒绝上帝.
Only people who accept Creator's eight people, Noah's family.
当时接受上帝的只有八个人，挪亚的一家人.
Then what is the Red Sea?
那红海.
When God finally led the people out of Egypt,
当上帝引领以色列人出埃及的时候,
God took them to the Red Sea.
把他们带到红海.
And God divided water.
上帝分开了水.
You know what that means?
什么意思呢?
I am the Creator.
我就是创造主.
Because the Creator created the earth by dividing water.
因为创造主创造了地的时候就分开了水.
And then all Israelites and other people who followed Moses,
当那些跟从摩西的以色列人,
says, wow, this God leading us out of Egypt is the Creator.
他们就认识到引领他们出埃及的是创造主.
So they trusted God.
所以他们就相信.
Yes, the God who is the Creator is leading us out.
是上帝创造主引领我们出来的.
Pharaoh came.
然后法老来了。
And Holy Spirit is speaking to Pharaoh.
这时候圣灵也对法老说话。
Pharaoh, my son.
他也对法老说，我的孩子。
I love you.
我也爱你。
Look at the Red Sea.
你看红海。
I divided the Red Sea.
我把它们分开了。
It is also for you.
也为你分开了一条。
I wish you trust me.
希望你信靠我。
Isn't and I a creator?
我就是创造主。
And Pharaoh says, No, it has nothing to do with creator.
法老说这和创造主没有
什么关系。This is simply coincidence.
只不过是偶然发生的事情。
God wanted to.Pharaoh know that he is the creator.
上帝想借着分开洪水，让他知道这是创造主。
God wanted to save him.
上帝要救他。
Pharaoh said.
法老说不需要。
Instead, he decided to follow and kill the Israelites.
他还要决定继续追杀以色列人。
Without believing the power which separates the divine water.
他都不相信分开洪海的这个力量。
When you don't trust.
根本不需要相信。
That means you didn't choose, you didn't make a choice.
不相信上帝，证明你不选择他。
Pharaoh made a choice not to believe in the power.
法老自己决定的选择就是不相信上帝的权柄。当他进来的时候，水就合上了。
Pharaoh died.
然后法老死了。
And God was crying, Oh Pharaoh, Pharaoh.
上帝其实也为这个法老哀哭。
That's judgment.
这就是审判。
So, what is a plague?
所以那七大那灾难呢
？Ten plagues.
那十大灾。
So you have to look everything the other way around.
所以你就会发现，看问题换了一个角度。
Like.See, God is controlling the ecological balances.
上帝也控制着生态平衡。
God can control all the genes.
上帝也控制着所有的基因。
So God can, you know, make a squirrel, you know, not to die.
所以那个土拨鼠。
And scare the snake away.
然后把小女生吓跑了。
All kind of things God can.
上帝有权能。
Without that kind of control,
如果没有这样的上帝的控制
，this nature will be just a mess.
大自然就一团糟。
So, God wanted Pharaoh know he is the creator.
上帝只是想让法老知道创造主是他。
But Pharaoh says,
但是法老硬着心。
He is God.
我就信我自己，我是神。
So God wanted Pharaoh to know that he is the God.
上帝想让他知道，是上帝是真正的创造主。
So, but Pharaoh refused to accept that.
法老拒绝接受。
So God said, let me make up this story here, short story.
让我讲这么一个故事哈。
I knew my sister Jisoo.
我认识这个赵姊妹。
Let's say she Jisoo is an orphan.
那我们假想她是一个孤儿。
I visited her in orphanage when she was only six years old.
她五岁的时候，我去孤儿院看她。
I found out she has future.
我觉得他这个孩子不错，有前途。
In that, even in that age, she looks different.
五岁不就大不一样。
She's, her eyes sparkling, you know.
看她的眼睛发光。
She's very positive.
她非常啊这样子。
And I decided, I'm going to, help her.
所以我想帮她一个忙。
But she is a very proud person.
但她很骄傲。
She did not want to accept my help.
她不想去接受别人的帮助。
But anyway, I secretly, I was helping her indirectly.
所以我就通过其他方式帮她.
When she got finally grew up and married,
她结了婚, 长大,
she could not get a job.
她找不到什么工作,
so I always sent her money.
所以我就给她钱,
without revealing who I am.
她也不知道是给钱,
so every month, there's $2,000 in the mailbox.
在他信箱里每个月都有两千块钱。Year after year。每个月都有，每个月都有，每一年都是。So
at the beginning, she was curious, who is sending me this money?
一开始他很明白，是谁给的钱这么好。But
after a few years, she's not even questioning anymore.
几年之后，他连问都不问了，这是他的钱。Every
first day of month, the money is supposed to be there in the mailbox.
不管怎么样，每月第一天都应该有钱的。It
became routine.
就成了一个。 日常的事情.
And then somebody came to me.
然后这时候有人来找我.
Said, Dr. Lee.
说李医生,
you have been helping Jisoo, right?
是你在帮助这个赵姊妹的吗?
But Jisoo chose to become a Mooney. Mooney, you know Mooney? Mr. Moon, Korean man. Who has a unified church? Okay.
Moody.
Moody. He's not. No,
Moon. Moon Sam Myung.
No, you know.
Now,
the famous
one, he founded a church. He's a founder. He's a
founder.
He's a founder. He's a founder.
韩国人，他要准备跟这个，
yeah. She's going to 통일교.
他要去统一教。
I said, what?
然后我说什么？
She's going to 통일교.
他要去统一教了。
I was shocked.
太吃惊了。
And so that person said, Doctor, you gotta do something.
医生，你得想想办法。
Then I sent someone.
然后这时候我就打发一个人
to tell her.
告诉耶稣,
I wanted her to become Adventist.
你应该成为安息日会的人.
But this is emergency.
这非常紧急的.
So I sent someone to tell her.
所以我打发人告诉他,
that it was Dr. Tsang Lee who was sending her money.
就告诉他是李医生给你的钱.
And Jesus says, I don't believe that.
我觉得不可能吧。
I don't believe he was the one who was sending money.
我不相信他给我的钱。
It is the same thing saying Pharaoh saying, I don't think God was helping me everything.
就像法老说, 我不相信上帝帮助了我。
And so what can I do?
所以这时候我怎么办?
What can I do? So I can let the Jisoo know that I was the one who has been helping her.
所以到底是我该怎么办才能让他知道我帮了他?
How can I let her know?
我怎么办让他知道? Stop the money.
That's no. Right. But God did not want to stop money entire $2,000.
但上帝不想停止所有的2000块钱.
Because God still loved her.
因为上帝还爱他。
So God decided only
$200.
Next time, next month, you'll have $1,800.
所以下一次一取钱，看只剩下1800了，那二百不见了。
So that's a template.
这就是世界。
And Jisoo opened the mailbox.
这时候，Jisoo打开。
And there's $1,800.
啊，钱少了200。
She was shocked.
他就很吃惊。
So at the beginning, she accepted that.
一开始他觉得好，就这样吧。
I am the one who has been helping her.
然后他就觉得，哎，可能是。
A few days later.
但是几天之后。
She said no, it's somebody else.
就可能不是李医生，是别人。
So she repeated that 10 times.
他10次都是这样翻来覆去，一会儿是，一会儿不是。
Like frogs.
就像蛙哉,
if God removed God's control,
如果上帝撤去他控制的手,
then frogs all over the place.
这个世界到处都是青蛙。
See, this is what the saying goes. If God take away his help,
如果上帝撤去他帮助的手,
then there's a plague.
就会有灾难。
Flies.
蝇灾。
Weather.
天气的灾难。
You know, all these cattle, cows, you know,
牛,
yeah, all these immune systems,
还有这些免疫系统的问题,
and the cattle dies.
那些牛, 牛死掉了,
so it is God is showing that I am the one who's been taking care of your cows.
上帝就想他知道, 是我照顾着你的牛,
I am the one who's been taking care of your weather.
是我也照顾着你的天气。
And Pharaoh said,
and
10 times,
十次,
God endured.
上帝都忍受了,
and the last plague was,
所以十大灾,第十灾是什么?
If I take off my hand away from your son,
如果我不保护你的孩子, 我撤去保护孩子的手,
firstborn child,
你的长子,
让他们死, and they died.
他们就真的死.
Pharaoh says no.
法老说, 不.
But yet God did not kill Pharaoh.
上帝还是没有杀死法老, 对吗?
Finally, Pharaoh gave up and okay, go.
这时候法老放弃了, 赶快走,
Israel, Israel, go.
赶快走.
God was very sad.
上帝觉得很难过.
Pharaoh says, I'm going to kill them.
我要杀那些人.
And God showed them sign.
上帝让他看到一个
sign of creator.
看到这个创造的迹象.
Water separated. And Pharaoh at the beginning, Pharaoh said, wow. This God is great.
他终于明白, 哦, 上帝就是创造主。
But he chose not to trust.
但是他还是不相信, 不选择不相信.
He chose his death.
他选择他的死, 他选择死.
That's right.
这就是灾难.
10 plagues.
十大灾.
7 plagues.
七大灾.
Which is coming.
就再来.
Same thing.
一样的.
God is not punishing them.
不是上帝在惩罚.
The people in this world will refuse.
这个世界上的人们还会拒绝.
That's why there will be plague.
这为什么会有灾难?
So, the new start and this kind of God's character goes together.
所以新起点和上帝的品格是走在一起的.
Then, new start will be a true new start.
所以这时候就成了真正的新的起点.